When we imagine galaxies, we often think of large groups of stars that appear to be spinning around a central point. This spinning motion is emphasized by a galaxy's spiral arms. These spiral arms can be approximated by what is known as a golden spiral. This type of spiral can be observed in many cases throughout nature. One way to approximate a golden spiral is by the following polar coordinate function. Given a specific angle, the corresponding radius is equal to a scaling factor times a constant to the power of the given angle. Let's translate this equation into ice. Drag a scalar node into the tree and set it to 1.0053611. Right-click in an empty space within the node and select Create Comment. To keep track of what this node represents with respect to our equation, we'll label it as C. Drag an exponent node into the tree. Connect its base input to C's output. Drag a scalar node into the tree. Set its value to 0 and identify it as theta. This is a placeholder for the input angle. Connect theta's output to the power port. Drag a multiply node into the tree. Then drag a scalar node into the tree. This scalar will represent the scaling factor. Let's label it as A. Set its value to 1 and connect it to the multiply node's first input. Connect the result of the exponent node to the second input of the multiply node. Let's label this result as R, the spiral's radius for the given angle. Since this part of the tree isn't connected to the root, it won't be evaluated yet. We can nonetheless convert these nodes into a single compound to make our tree less cluttered. Highlight the nodes and select Compounds, Create Compound. A compound acts just like a function when you're scripting. It can have multiple inputs and outputs. To expand the compound, mouse over it and click on the small e. Delete the theta node. This was simply a placeholder to better understand how to translate the function into ice. Click and drag the exponent's power port to the upper left dot to turn it into the component's input. Expand the following region and rename the new input to theta. To create an output, connect the multiply node's result port to the upper right dot. Rename this output value to radius. Rename the compound to golden spiral. Exit the compound by clicking on the curved arrow. This returns us back to the parent ice tree. We now want to use this compound to define a spiral containing 100 particles. Disconnect the build index array node and delete its integer to scalar node. Drag an integer node into the tree and set its value to 100. Connect this integer to the index array's size input. Let's say we want our spiral to sweep an angle of 720 degrees. Drag a scalar node into the tree and give it a value of 720. We want to spread the 100 particles along the spiral. Drag a divide by scalar node into the tree. Connect the 720 node to the value port. Connect the 100 node to the divide by port. The result is the number of degrees that separates each particle, or the angle step. Drag a multiply node into the tree. Connect the angle step to the first input value. Connect the index array to the second input value. Connect the multiplications result to the theta input of the golden spiral compound. To visualize what we're doing, the elements in the index array are multiplied by the angle step. The result is an increasing angle, which is transformed by the golden spiral compound into its corresponding radius length. Here's where a bit of trigonometry comes into play. Given an angle theta and a radius r, the corresponding xy coordinates are as follows. The corresponding x coordinate is r times cos theta. Likewise, the corresponding y-coordinate is r times sine theta. Since we'll be creating our galaxy on the xz plane, we just have to replace y by z and keep y at 0. Drag a cos node into the tree, and drag a sine node into the tree. Drag a multiply node into the tree, and copy that node since we'll be multiplying the radius twice, once for the x-axis and one for the z-axis. Let's take a second to rearrange our tree. Connect the radius port to the first value of both multiply nodes. Connect the result of the left multiply node into the input values of the cos and sine nodes. Connect the result of the cos and sine nodes into the second values of the two multiply nodes. Now connect the top multiply node to the x input of the scalar to 3D vector node. Connect the bottom multiply node to the z input of the scalar to 3D vector node. We now have a spiral of particles in the viewport. To keep our ice tree clean, let's turn the following nodes into a compound. Rename the first input value to swept angle. Rename the second input value to num particles. Rename the third input value to indices. Rename the output value to particle positions. Finally, rename the compound to generate spiral. In the next part, we'll cover how to repeat this spiral to create a particle galaxy.